In today's discussion, we'll start a new topic, and this loop analysis, sometimes it's also called as mesh analysis. You already know what's the difference between loop and mesh. Loop is a closed path, whereas mesh is also a loop, but it doesn't contain any other loops inside it. Say if at all, say I consider one network, let us consider this is a simple network containing, say for example, two voltage sources and three resistors, okay? Say I call this as a E1, this as a E2, and let me call this as R1, R2 and R3. Say this is one mesh, this is another mesh. Whereas in this network, there are three loops. This is one loop, this is another loop, and this is the third one. Even this is also a loop. If you see this network, it contains three loops, whereas there are only two meshes. So, because mesh is a loop which doesn't contain any other loops inside it. I cannot consider this as a mesh because it contains two loops inside it. So loop analysis is also called as mesh analysis. This is one of the way to analyze a given network. So analysis means you already know, given a network with its elements value, we are supposed to find the currents and resistors in the network. That is called analysis. Say this is one more method, so because previously we have discussed using KVL, using KCL, even basic Ohm's law and voltage division rule, current division rule, we have done analysis. This is one more analysis that we are going to do, which is termed as a loop analysis. It is very simple. What we are going to do in this particular method is we are going to get equations, which we call it as a loop equations or mesh equations. So we'll get a loop or mesh equations, because if we call this as a loop analysis, then I say it as a loop equations. If we call it as a mesh analysis, then we call it as a mesh equations, right? Say here, say important thing, dear students, we are going to get equations, and later those equations will be solved simultaneously, either using a normal approach, simultaneously solving those equations, otherwise using a determinant methods. Okay, say one of the methods we can use to solve a given loop equations. Say like, say for example, and one more thing, very important thing here is, if at all we want to solve any problem using a loop analysis, then how many loops will be there, those many equations should be there. Or say for example, how many unknowns will be there, those many equations must be there. If I have three unknowns like I1, I2, I3, I should, to solve this, I should get three equations. Then only I can solve, otherwise we cannot solve it. Okay, say how many unknowns are there, those many equations we should get, means those many times you should apply a KVL to get the loop equations, right? The first problem is problem number one. Is this the first problem? Problems on loop analysis. Okay, find the current through each resistor of the network shown in figure 1.1. Okay, so this is a figure 1.1, right? Say here, say we have three resistors and two voltage sources. Okay, say here to solve this particular problem, we need to get two loop equations. Let us start the solution. As there are two loops, arbitrarily we can assume any current direction. Like say for example, here there is one loop and here there is another loop. Say I call it as a one mesh and this is another mesh. Okay, so what I do here, I'm going to assume some arbitrary, means some conventional current you can assume. Let me assume in this direction. You can assume current direction in a current in any directions, either in clockwise or anti-clockwise. In a loop one, this I term it as a loop one or mesh one, this I term it as a mesh two or loop two. In mesh one, I'll apply current in clockwise direction, and that loop current or mesh current I call it as I1. And say in case of mesh 2 or loop 2, I apply current in anti-clockwise direction. You can apply both in clockwise direction or both in anti-clockwise direction. Say now what I do, say very simple, I am going to develop a mesh equations or loop equations. Applying KVL to loop 1, say loop 1 means this. Okay, if I apply KVL to loop 1, say dear students, this is negative of the battery, this is positive of the battery. The current always flows from positive terminal through the network to negative terminal. Say what I do, say conventionally I consider minus to plus, if I am moving from minus to plus, I consider that as a positive, so it is even. And here current always flows from high potential to low potential, so I consider this as positive and this as negative. So positive to negative, here negative to positive, I have considered positive. Positive to negative, opposite of that, minus I1 R1. So here also, say this is plus, this is minus, plus to minus, minus. Look at dear students, here the resistance is R3, but the two currents will flow through this resistor. One is I1 and another one is I2. Both will add up because both are in same direction. If both are in opposite direction, no, then according to their direction, say for example, if I2 is in upward direction, as per this I1, I2 is in downward direction, even I1 is also downward direction. If I consider I2 in a clockwise direction, then I2 would be in upward direction. In that case, here you should write R3 into I1 minus I2. Why I1 minus I2? Because you are applying KVL to loop 1. You are there in loop 1. Say loop 1, I1 will be positive and other current will be taken with reference to the loop current, which is I1 here. If other current is in same direction of this current, then both will add up. If other current is in opposite direction, then that will subtract from this current. So now here, this is equal to 0, right? Now, say I'll substitute the values, okay? So before that, say even one more step, I can write it. E1 minus, say this is I1 R1 minus I1 R3 minus I2 R3 is equal to 0. Or say for example, see if I take all this, that side, so we'll get I1 will be taken common, okay? So inside the bracket, R1 plus R3 plus of I2 R3 is equal to E1. And say if I substitute the values, I1 into, say R1 is how much? It is 4 plus R3 is 8. Plus of I2 R3 is 8 ohm is equal to E1 is, it is 6 volts. Okay. Or 12 I1 plus 8 I2 is equal to 6. Call this as equation number 1. This is E1 is 4 volts. Not it's 6 volts, it's 4 volts. So now, similarly what I do, I'll develop an equation for loop 2. Okay. Say so here I'll write applying KVL to loop 2. So we get, what we get? So let us see now for loop 2. So here minus 2 plus, I'll consider 6. Directly now I'm writing directly. Okay. So here, because the current is flowing in this direction, this is positive, this is negative. Plus 2 minus, minus 2, directly I'm writing 2 I2. And here plus 2 minus, minus, say current is, resistance is 8. Currents are, look at dear students now, we'll write I2 plus I1, which is nothing but I1 plus I2 only. Okay, so is equal to 0. Or 6 minus 2 I2 minus 8 I1 minus 8 I2 is equal to 0. Right? So here, say this is minus 8 I1 minus 10 I2 plus 6 equal to 0. Or you can write it as 8 I1 plus 10 I2 is equal to 6. Call this as equation number 2. Right? So now you have two equations with you. One is equation 1 and another is equation 2. Simultaneously, we can solve both the equations. Okay? So solving both the equations. Now here I'll write solving for, say for example, you are solving for I1. Let us consider solving for I1. Say here it is 12, it is 8 year. Say I should consider 8 and 10 year. I want to cancel I2. Say for example, this equation I'll multiply by 10 and this equation I'll multiply by 8 to cancel out I2. So if I multiply this, it is 120 I1 plus 80 I2 is equal to 40. And what about equation 2? That I'm multiplying by 8. 8 is this, this is 64. And this is 80 I2 is equal to, so this is 48. Now it is right, okay. So what I do, so I'll subtract it, minus, this is minus, this is minus, this will get cancelled, and what you get, it is 120 minus 120 minus 64 is equal to, it is 56 I1 is equal to minus 8, right? Say 56 I1 is minus 8, or I1 is equal to, say how much you will get I1? 8 by 56 is equal to, it is 0.14286. Sign is negative, so I'll write I1 is this. Similarly, what I do, I take this I1, now substituting I1 in one of the equation, you can substitute either in equation 1 or equation 2. As you wish, I will substitute I1 in equation 1. Okay, equation 1 implies our I1 is minus 0.14286 ampere is our I1. Say we take this in equation, say 1, say for example, equation 1 is 8I2 is equal to, it is 4 minus 12I1. And this is equal to, say 4 minus 12 into minus of 0.14286 milliampere. 12 into 0.14286 is equal to, say this is 1.71432. Say this is 8I2, or I2 is equal to divided by, say this is plus 4 divided by 8, 0.71429 milliampere is your I2. See, you have found I1, say which is equal to minus 0.14286 milliampere. You have found I2, that is equal to 0.71429 milliampere. But say we are supposed to find, as per the given problem, say we are supposed to find, what we are supposed to find, current through each resistor of the network. As there are three resistors, we should find three currents. First current is through R1. This current, I call it as IR1. The current through this resistor, I call it as IR1. Okay. So the current through this resistor, I call it as IR2. And current through this R3, I call it as IR3. Three currents, right? So now here, say, if you refer this figure 1.1, the current IR1 is in same direction of I1, the current IR2 is in same direction of I2, and current IR3 is sum of I1 plus I2. So very simple, you can directly now write. Now, current through R1 is, so what is it? It is IR1 is equal to I1, which is equal to minus 4.14286 milliampere. So that is your IR. And current through R2 is IR2, which is equal to, say IR2 is equal to I2. So therefore, IR2 is equal to, I2 is 0.71429 milliampere. And now lastly, finally, current through R3 is IR3, which is equal to, it is I1 plus I2. So therefore, IR3 is equal to I1 plus I2, say I1 is how much? So that is minus 0.41286 milliampere, plus of I2 is 0.71429 milliampere. Say IR3 will be equal to, say if you do this, this is already I2, minus of I1 is 0.14286 is equal to, so it is 0.57143 milliampere. So this is IR. If you see, dear students, IR1 is negative. The meaning of that is the current through R1 is flowing from, say, this point to this point. Means here, right to left. So means, but we have assumed the current from left to right. Means actual current direction is opposite of assumed the current direction. That is the meaning of negative sign here, right? So a very important thing, dear students, even you can write it, the current, say, later, the negative sign indicates that the current is in opposite direction of assumed current direction. Okay, so if you assume currents in opposite directions, in any other directions, finally, say, you will be getting, the value will be same, but the current direction will be, means the sign will be either positive or negative. Okay, say, but if you club the sign and the direction that you have assumed both, then your solution will be exactly equal to any other solution, means my solution. Okay, so here, because let us consider you might have assumed I1 in this direction, or say IR1 in opposite direction. Okay, say in this direction, then say you would have got say this R1 is equal to directly, say instead of negative, 0.14286, right? So in that case, you need say you don't get a negative sign, because you were assumed the direction and the actual current direction will be same, right? So this is a very simple problem on loop analysis. So what we have done, we have say, because there are two loops, or say I say two meshes. Okay, so why it is called as mesh analysis? Because we solve based on the mesh. How many meshes are there, those many mesh equations will develop. Because of that, this particular method is also called as mesh analysis. Okay, so we should develop, say if there are two meshes, we should develop two mesh equations, or three mesh equations accordingly. Okay, so here we developed two mesh equations and we have solved them simultaneously. Even to solve this for I1 and I2, we can use a determinant method also, that we'll see in a next problem. Yes, this is the second problem on loop or mesh analysis. So here, find the currents. Let us solve this using determinant method. Say, find the currents through each resistor of the network shown in figure 2.1. This is the figure 2.1. So where you have 1, 2, 3, 4 resistors and two current sources. All right. Say, but it has got only two meshes. One mesh is this and another one is this. Okay. So let me start with a solution. So here what I do, I'm going to assume two mesh currents. Say here, say I'll assume current in this direction in first mesh. This I call it as mesh 1 and this as mesh 2, or loop 1 and loop 2. Say here I have assumed current in this direction, and here also let me assume the current in this direction. This current I call it as I1 and this I call it as I2. Right? So I1 and I2, two currents. Okay, you can assume in any direction. So I have selected some arbitrary current directions. Okay, so initially applying KVL loop 1, say we get what we get. Say this is loop 1. Say here, say plus 2 minus, if say, because the current direction has been applied in this direction, plus 2 minus, choice is yours. Either you can consider positive or negative. If you consider plus 2 minus as positive, minus 2 plus, you should consider negative. Choice is yours. Say here I'll consider plus 2 minus, if I consider positive, so that is a 9. Here also plus 2 minus, that will be plus of 1.2k I1. So then here it is, look at this, it is current is flowing in this direction, plus 2 minus plus. Okay, say resistance is 8.2k and currents are both are in same direction, because of that I1 plus I2 is equal to 0. Very simple, right? So otherwise what I do, say it is 1.2 plus 8.2 is 9.4 kilo I1, and this is plus of 8.2 kilo I2 is equal to minus 9. Call this as equation number 1. So now, say what I do, applying KVL to loop 2, we get, say this is loop 2, say minus 2 plus, here this time I'll consider positive, that is 6. Choice is yours. Plus 2 minus will be minus 9.1k and current is I2. Once again here plus 2 minus, this time it is minus. Resistance is 8.2k and currents are I1 plus I2. Both are in same direction. And this one, say plus 2 minus, I'll consider minus. It is 1.1k I2 is equal to 0. So say 6 minus, say I1 is only 1 here, so that is 8.2k I1 minus of, say if you say add up remaining all I2, say 1 is 9.1k plus 8.2k plus 1.1k is equal to, it is 18.4k I2 is equal to 0. Say if I write 8.2k I1 plus of 18.4 KI2 is equal to 6. Call this as equation number 2. Now we have two equations. To solve for I1 and I2, we use a determinant method. Say a determinant method can be easily used. So I'll write a determinant for these two equations. Say here, first matrix, this second for which particular parameter we are solving. And this is solution matrix, answer matrix. Right? Say here, first one is, if you see this, it is 9.4, this is 8.2, and this is minus 9. Okay. Say here, I'll write first is 9.4k, second, say it is 8.2k, and this one is I1. Okay, for the first one, this is minus 9, and the second equation, it is 8.2k, and it is 18.4k, and this is I2. Is 6. Now say find delta is equal to, it's just this equation. Okay, say it is 9.4k into 18.4k. say here minus this one is 8.2k into 8.2. say this is equal to, so just try to calculate this, 9.4k into 18.4k minus of 8.2k into 8.2k is equal to, yes, how much is this? It is 10.1052 mega into 10 power 6. This is nothing but 10.52 into 10 power 6. Now I'll find delta 1. Delta 1 is equal to, how do we find delta 1? We'll replace first column by answer matrix. That is minus 9 and 6. And this will be, second column will be as it is, 2.8k. And this is 18.4k, and this is equal to, so now delta 1 is, say I'll multiply directly now, say look at this, it is 9 into 18.4k and plus into minus, minus 6 into 8.2k will be equal to, say it is minus 214.8k. And now say similarly I'll find delta 2 also. Delta 2 will be equal to, say first column will be kept as it is. This is 9.4k, this is 8.2k, and in second column we will replace answer, that is minus 9 and 6. And now this is equal to, say directly I'll calculate, one is 9.4k into 6, minus into minus will be plus. Okay, so this minus into minus will be plus 9 into 8.2k is equal to, it is 130.2k. So now say you can find the currents, very simple dear students. Your I1 will be delta 1 divided by delta, which is equal to I2 will be similarly delta 2 divided by delta. Delta 2 is already there with me, it is 130.2k divided by delta is, it is 105.72 mega is equal to, say 1.23, say it is milliampere. And I1 will be, say delta 1 is how much? It is 214. Say this will be minus because it is 214.8k divided by, say 105.72 mega is equal to, it is 2.032 milliampere. So we have found I1 and I2. Now, say as per the current directions, let us find remaining currents through all the resistors. So here I'll write first before I proceed further. So what's my I1? I1 will be equal to minus 2.032 milliampere, and I2 is equal to 1.23 milliampere. Say let us assume the current directions here. Even before you proceed further, you can assume the current directions. Here let me assume this current direction. I'll assume in any arbitrary current direction you can assume. Let me assume here current direction in this, just arbitrary current. Okay, and here say let me assume in this direction, and say here in this direction, that is IR3, and here in this direction, that is IR4. So now comparing I1 and I2, say IR1 is in this direction, whereas I2 is in opposite direction, because in this loop the current is flowing in this direction, means IR1 current through here, you can write current through R1 is IR1 is equal to, it is minus of I1. Therefore, IR1 is equal to, say minus into minus plus, it is 2.032 milliampere. How IR1 is flowing? In this direction. Okay. So means from left to right, it is now current through IR2. And so if you see current through R2, this is R2. R2 is in opposite direction of I1 and I2. That means IR2 is equal to minus of I1 minus of I2, because both are in opposite direction. And say this is IR2 is equal to minus of I1. I1 is minus into minus plus, you will get 2.032 milliampere, right? And minus of I2 is 1.23 milliampere. So IR2 is equal to 2.032 minus of 1.23 is 0.802 milliampere is IR2. So now, say you are supposed to find current through R3. So which is R3 is IR3. And that IR3 is equal to, say R3 and R4, the current directions are same, and same current. Only one current can, because both are in series, only one current will flow through that. Current through R3 and R4. Say both will be IR3 is equal to IR4. So which is equal to, so look at this, both are in same direction, four are in same direction, I'll write it is equal to I2. Therefore, IR3 is equal to IR4 is equal to, so I2 value is how much? I2 is 1.23 milliampere. So this is how you are supposed to solve. So two methods I have told, one by using a simultaneous equation, simultaneously you can solve. The second by using a determinant method. So simple two problems have solved in today's class. So as to show you the method. So whereas in tomorrow's class, whatever I'm going to engage there, so I'm going to solve some more problems of little bit difficulty.